after the president named the Iraq Commission. His chief security aide, Condoleezza Rice, was questioned today in another intelligence investigation. Its focus, whether the September 11th attacks on America could have been prevented. Randall Pinkston has that story.
In a closed-door meeting at the White House, National Security Advisor Condoleezza Rice met with the panel investigating the 9/11 terrorist attacks, the highest member yet of the president's staff to appear. Neither her comments nor the panel's questions have been revealed. But 9/11 family members like Lori Van Auken, whose husband was killed in the attack, hope the panel examines questions raised in this report, released in 2002 by the Joint Congressional Intelligence Committee. It outlined a series of intelligence warnings about airplanes being used as weapons.
In 95, a plane might be crashed into CIA headquarters. In 96, some key Al-Qaeda operative might fly to the United States from Afghanistan and attack the White House. From 98, Al-Qaeda planned to fly an explosive-laden plane from a foreign country into the World Trade Center.
In all, there were 12 warnings over 7 years, from 1994 to 2001. But in May 2002, 8 months after the 9/11 attacks, Rice made a comment Van Auken finds inexplicable.
I don't think anybody could have predicted that they would try to use an airplane as a missile, a hijacked airplane as a missile.
But couldn't Condoleezza Rice argue that she wasn't aware that those kind of warnings weren't raised to the level where she would have seen them?
She's the national security advisor. If she didn't know the information about these threats, why didn't she know about these threats?
Other high-ranking members of the Bush administration are expected to appear before the 9/11 panel, as well as former officials from the Clinton administration. But 9/11 family members say all should be required to testify under oath. They were told that Rice would not be sworn in.
No specific threat involving really a domestic operation involving what happened, obviously, with cities, airliner, and so forth.
No warning signs that I'm aware of that would indicate this type of operation in the country.
President Bush was told in August that Osama bin Laden might be planning an attack involving the hijacking of U.S. aircraft.
Dan, it was a revelation that the White House had no intention of making public. And officials spent the entire day in full damage control.
I don't think anybody could have predicted that they would try to use an airplane as a missile, a hijacked airplane as a missile.
Nobody in our government, at least, and I don't think the prior government that could envision flying airplanes into buildings on such a massive scale.
I'd like to ask you about the August 6th PDB.
Sure.
You mentioned it.
2 years later, President Bush responded to questions about what led him to request the August 6th briefing.
Ed, I asked for the briefing. And the reason I did is because there had been a lot of threat intelligence from overseas.
His spokesperson, Ari Fleischer, and his national security advisor, Condi Rice, were more than aware of the threat of planes as weapons. But the news media appeared to miss the lead.
You have information about simultaneous hijackings.
No specific threat.
Planes being used as weapons.
I don't think anybody could have predicted.
Specific targets, including mentions of Pentagon, World Trade Center.
Nobody in our government, at least, and I don't think the prior government could envision flying airplanes into buildings.
Dr. Rice, would you please rise and raise your right hand? You swear or affirm to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth.
In April 2004, public pressure finally forced the White House to allow Dr. Rice to testify before the 9/11 Commission to answer questions about the PDB and the nature of warnings given the administration.
The threat reporting that we received in the spring and summer of 2001 was not specific as to time, nor place, nor manner of attack. Almost all of the reports focused on Al-Qaeda activities outside the United States. What the August 6th PDB said, and perhaps I should
read it to you.
We would be happy to have it declassified in full.
When she was testifying, one Ben Denise was really trying to get into the living room.
Did you tell the president at any time prior to August 6th of the existence of Al-Qaeda cells in the United States?
First, let me just make certain.
If you could just answer that question,
first,
because I only have a very limited...
I understand, Commissioner, but
it's important
that I also address... I really don't remember, Commissioner, whether I discussed this with the president.
Let me move on, if I may.
There were no specifics.
What about August 6th? What did August 6th memo say? And then she would start going off.
It was historical information based on old reporting. There was no new threat information, and it did not, in fact, warn of any coming attacks inside the United States.
And what was the title of the memo?
I believe the title was Bin Laden Determined to Attack Inside the United States.
Two weeks later, the White House finally declassified the PDB.
There's lots of examples where it's a domestic threat. Bin Laden told followers he wanted to retaliate in Washington. You know, Bin Laden was planning to exploit the operative actors to the U.S. to mount a terrorist strike. Abu Zubaydah was planning his own U.S. attack. Plus, FBI information since that time indicates patterns of suspicious activity in this country, consistent with preparations for hijackings or other types of attacks, including recent surveillance of federal buildings in New York. That's present tense and domestic.
Army Fleischer came out right after September 11th and said there were no warnings. I watched him tell me there were no warnings, okay? I want to know why. Nobody has gone back and said, what did he mean?
Howard Dean recently seemed to muse aloud whether you had advanced knowledge of 9/11.
Yeah, there's time for politics. And, it's time for politics, and, it's an absurd insinuation.
The press has reported this one, that one, but they haven't really put it all together and said, God, how many different warnings did you get? How many different ways was this information coming at you? And why wasn't anything done about all these warnings?